The purpose of this video is to present some of the most commonly used features that are available when editing YAML documents in Oxygen XML Editor. I'll start with a sample YAML document opened in Oxygen. It contains data about a group of people. The first thing I want to highlight is the YAML outline view. It displays the node structure within the YAML document and the dependencies between its components. And notice that it is synchronized with the main editor, so when I select something in the editor, the corresponding node is highlighted in the outline view, and if I select a node in the outline view, the corresponding data is highlighted in the editor. The text filter at the top of the outline view can be used to focus on a particular subset of components. Note that YAML uses Python-style indentation for nesting, and that's why you see all those special dots at the beginning of the lines. These markers represent space characters that YAML uses for indentation and really help you when editing YAML documents because wrong indentation on a key causes the document to be not well formed. Notice that the automatic validation presented the error in the editor as well as in the outline view. I'll remove the extra space to correct the error. Now I'll open a sample JSON schema file that defines rules regarding the structure and possible values of properties and keys in the YAML document. Oxygen uses associated schemas for both validation and assisted content completion. I'll go back to the YAML document and show you that there are two ways to associate a JSON schema to a YAML document in Oxygen. The first method is to configure a new validation scenario that binds the schema to the YAML document. I'll click the settings icon to the right of the validation unit to select my JSON schema file, and I'll complete the process to save the association. The second method is to associate the schema directly in the YAML document. In Oxygen, I can do this by clicking the Associate Schema toolbar button. Then I'll select the JSON schema. I'll enable the Use Path Relative to the File Location option and click OK. And you can see that the schema is now referenced directly in the YAML document in line 2. Note that if both methods are used to associate a schema, then the schema specified in the validation scenario has a higher priority and hence is the one that will be used by the validation engine. Now that a schema is associated, I'll click the validation button and you'll notice that there are a few errors reported. I'll click on the first error message in the results view that reports a non-valid email address. I'll go ahead and fix it, and that error is no longer reported. Now I'll click on the second error that signals there is a required link key that has no value. I'll right-click the link property and select Go to Definition. This takes us to that particular property's definition in the schema. Notice that there is a thick bold line connecting it from the properties group component. This indicates that it is required. I'll click the arrow at the end of that component to navigate to its definition to continue the analysis of the requirements. We can see that the link property should contain subordinates or manager keys. Now I'll click the Go to Definition arrow on one of those keys. And the conclusion from the analysis is that subordinates is defined as an array of string values, while manager is defined as a single string value with up to 20 characters. So now I'll go back to the YAML document to correct the error. As I mentioned before, one major benefit of associating a schema to the YAML document is that it provides the ability to use the content completion assistant that proposes the properties that can be inserted at the current location. I'll place the cursor at the end of the link construct, click Enter, add two blank spaces for the correct indentation. Then I'll use Control Space to trigger the content completion, and I'll choose Manager from the list of proposals that are valid in this location. The errors and the results view disappeared and the document is now valid. Next, I'll demonstrate creating a YAML file from scratch. I'll click the New File button on the toolbar. I'll find and select the YAML template. I'll click Customize. I'll select my JSON schema. And in my case, I want all three of these options enabled. And I'll click Create to finish the document creation process. The resulting YAML file conforms with the structure and data restrictions expressed in the JSON schema I selected, and it contains a person item in a personnel list. I could add more structure in the new document using proper YAML indentation. And the content completion assistant. And I can edit any inserted default values according to my needs. And I could continue to add the next property. And so on. Now, conversions between YAML and JSON are often necessary, and Oxygen provides some very useful conversion tools that I will show you next. First, I'll convert a YAML document to JSON. So I'll go to the Tools menu, then JSON Tools, and I'll select YAML to JSON. I'll select my YAML document for the input file. I'll leave the output location as is and click Convert. I'll open the two files side by side to compare them. The conversion mapping in this case is quite straightforward, with small differences between the two based on the differences in the syntax language of the two document types. Oxygen also includes a tool for converting JSON to YAML. This type of conversion is very similar to the other one, but in this case you specify the URL of a JSON file for the input, and I'll change the name of the output file. And it results in a converted YAML file. Those two conversion tools are for individual files, but Oxygen also offers support for batch converting multiple files at once. To do this, you need to install an additional batch converter add-on that provides numerous batch conversion actions, and more information about this add-on can be found in our user guide. That concludes this demonstration of the YAML editing features included in Oxygen. Thank you for watching. We welcome you to subscribe to our various social media channels, and we always welcome your feedback and suggestions.